My name is Loyd Leefland. I was born in South America, Suriname. I started working from early 17 years old. I was working at the hotel and casino resort called the Lely Hills, and I was a technician there. So I would take care of all the equipment like air conditionings and stuff like that. Basically, on this particular day when I met my partner, I was on standby call. And so I got this call and I had to go to work and go and check this air conditioning room B2, where these two ladies from London started talking to me and asking me, you know, if I was familiar with the area and stuff, if I was driving and if I knew clubs and stuff, if I could bring them out to see places and stuff. So I agreed, brought them away and stuff. You know, me and my partner started liking each other, and that's where it started, because she came the year after and then she came back the year after that. So it started in 1998. She came back in 1999, came back in 2000. And then I think in the middle of 2000, I came to England. Yeah, so basically my partner was pregnant, you know, got pregnant in my country and then come over here. We were talking about, you know, like what was gonna happen, you know, because obviously I didn't wanna stay away from my children, you know what I mean? I wanna be together with my kids. So we spoke about it and I decided to come to live in England and settle down instead of her coming to my country and settling down there. As you can see, this is my first son, Rivaldo. And then on this picture, on this side, you can see Lacoste Leefland, which is the second son. As you can see, the whole family again. That's my partner. Got Shakira following there. This was a picture of me and Cavani just here at home. Third son. When my son was born and stuff, I went to college. So the first 3 years I was here, I was doing English GCSEs level one. Started working because I needed money. I had to provide for my kids. So I started working. I started doing people's garden for a living. Like basically I bought this old estate, Volvo estate, and I started doing people's gardens. I ended up doing this old lady's garden, and the old lady basically sent me to the council to go and basically pick up the payment. The council would pay all her, like, you know, basically like if something had to do to the garden maintenance or whatever, not the council would pay for it. So when I went to the council, there's where I showed them the job that I've done. They paid me and asked me if I was willing to do more jobs, you know, and I said yeah, I've done a few more jobs, and they gave me a contract. This is the living room. Basically, since I had my operations, I can't really sleep upstairs anymore. It's like I can't go up and down the stairs. This is where I sleep. This is my bed now. So this is basically how I spend my days. You know, I'm not allowed to work, so basically I just sit here all day. You know, I do get a bit of help from overseas and stuff, but this is basically what it's come to. As you can see as well, the top, there's lots of mold everywhere in the house. I've complained about it, but I guess because, you know, my conditions, my restrictions, they're not doing anything about it. They're not really bothered, but I know it's not healthy for me. I was stopped from working in 2014. My passport got destroyed. When my passport got destroyed, and I decided to, you know, like, ask what's going on, and gone to the Home Office and stuff and asked them, like, you know, what's gonna happen, how do I get it back and stuff. Then basically they explained to me that, you know, I wasn't even on their system. So I was like, you know, how can that happen, you know what I mean? I got my visa, you know, it's been issued by a British counselor, you know what I mean, that sits in my country. So, you know, I know his name and everything, but they basically told me that there's nothing they can do because, you know, I have to go back and trace my steps, you know, where I got it issued, and then just get it issued back into my passport and then come back. Around October, September time, I woke up one morning ready to get the children to school and stuff, and I heard a knock. My partner was downstairs with, like, I think two or three of the children. She said to me that there was immigration at the door, so basically there was armed
guards and everything around the house, surrounded the house. Basically, what they have told me is that, you know, I mean, I don't have no right to stay in the country. So I had asked, you know, why and this and that, you know. Basically, what they tried to do to me that day is remove me from my house and bring me to a detention center and, you know, to remove me from the country. They took me all the way to Lincolnshire, to some massive prison there, and then brought me there and locked me up. After 2 months, they've released me on the temporary admission just to take me a second time from my family later on in the year. So in November of that same year, 2017, they took me a second time and then they released me. So then they've took me a third time. This is the year after that. This is 2018 in February. This time now, when they took me and put me back in there, I've literally given up. You know, I've given up fighting. You know, I mean, I've given up. I've always worked all my life, you know. I mean, it's like from a young age. Working basically, you know, would literally like sort everything out, you know what I mean? Because I'll be able to look after myself. You know, I've got children as well. It's not just me. Working really and truly, you know, basically can say it's saving my life.
Can you talk about how that made you feel, that you can provide your kids with what they wanted?
Wow. Sometimes it made me really sad, and you know, at times it made me angry, you know, because you know it's like, you know, because the more you tell them that, you know, it's like I don't have it, you know, and then another one will ask you something. You know, it's like it made me feel useless, you know, if that's the right word to use, you know, because, you know, I got, you know, I'm not disabled, you know, I've got 2 arms, I got legs, you know, I'm healthy, you know, so I should be able to provide for my children, you know, I mean, I shouldn't be knocking on neighbors' doors and saying, oh, can I have a bit of sugar, can I have a bit of milk, you know, I mean, or ask my friend, say, yo, listen, my son's birthday's coming up, can you, like, give me a 5 or a 10 or something, you know, I mean, it made me feel really useless, you know, I mean.